Shri Paramatmane Namaha.
I bow down to the Supreme Consciousness.
Atha Srimad Bhagavad Gita.
And now we start the Holy Bhagavad Gita.
Prathamodhyayah Arjuna Vishada Yoga.
Thus starts the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita, which describes Arjuna's suffering.
Dhritarashtra Uvacha.
The first shloka of Bhagavad Gita starts with a question. The blind king Dhritarashtra, sitting in his palace, asks his minister Sanjaya this question.
Dharma Kshetre Kurukshetre Samaveta Yuyutsavah Mamaka Pandavaschaiva Kimakurvata Sanjaya.
He asks, O Sanjaya, after gathering on the field of Kurukshetra, where the law is upheld, a Dharma Kshetra, and desiring to fight, what did my sons and the sons of Pandu do?
Sanjaya Uvacha.
Then the minister Sanjaya spoke the following words.
Drishtva tu Pandavanikam Vyudham Duryodhanastada Acharyamupasangamya Raja Vachanamabravit.
O king, after watching the battle formation of Pandavas, King Duryodhana approached his teacher Dronacharya and said the following words.
Pashyaitam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum Vyudham Drupada Putrena Tava Shishena Dhimata.
Behold the mighty formation of the sons of Pandu, which has been planned by your own gifted disciple, the son of Drupada. In the next three shlokas, he goes on to list out the warriors on the Pandava side of the battlefield.
Atra Shura Maheshwasa Bhimarjuna Samayudhi Yuyudhano Viratascha Drupadascha Maharathah.
Here stand many powerful warriors like Yuyudhana, Virata and Drupada, wielding mighty bows and equal in military prowess to Bhima and Arjuna.
Dhrushtaketusche Kitanah Kashi Rajascha Viryavan Purujit Kunti Bhojascha Shaibyascha Narapungavah.
There are also valorous fighters like Dhrushtaketu, Chekitana, the powerful king of Kashi, Purujit, Kunti Bhoja, and Shaibya, all of whom are the best of men.
Yudhamanyuscha Vikranta Uttamaujascha Viryavan Saubhadro Draupadeyascha Sarva Eva Maharathah.
In their ranks, they also have the courageous Yudhamanyu, the gallant Uttamauja, the son of Subhadra. They also have the sons of Draupadi, who are all great warrior chiefs.
Asmakam tu Vishishtaye Tanni Bodhadvijottama Nayaka Mama Sainyasya Sanyartham Tan Bravimite.
O best of Brahmins, you already are well versed with the special warriors on our side. I will recount the names of the leaders of my army formation to you.
Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnascha Krupascha Samitinjayah Ashwatthama Vikarnascha Saumadattisthathaivacha.
On our side there is Bhishma, Karna, Kripa, Ashwatthama, Vikarna and Saumadatti, who are all ever victorious in a battle.
Anye cha bahavah shura madharthe tyakta jivitah nana shastra praharana sarve yuddha visharadah.
Also, there are many other valorous warriors who are all prepared to lay down their lives for my sake. They are all skilled in the art of warfare and equipped with various kinds of weapons.
Aparyaptam tadasmakam balam bhishmabhirakshitam paryaptam tvidametesham balam bhimabhirakshitam.
The strength of our army is unlimited and is protected by Pitamaha Bhishma, while the strength of Pandava army, protected by Bhima, is limited. With the next shloka, Duryodhana gives out an order to his army. He says,
Ayaneshu cha sarveshu yatha bhagam avasthitah bhishma meva bhirakshantu bhavantah sarva evahi.
All of the leaders of my army, standing at the strategic entrances to my battle formation, protect Bhishma at all costs.
Tasya sanjanayan harsham kuru vriddhah pitamahah simhanadam vinadyochaihi shankham dadhmau pratapavan.
Then the grand old man of the Kuru dynasty, the glorious Pitamaha Bhishma, roared like a lion and blew his conch loudly, signaling the start of the battle and giving joy to Duryodhana.
Tata shankhascha bhiryascha panavanaka gomukhaha sahasaivabhyahanyanta sashabdastu mulobhavat.
Immediately, various battle instruments like conches, drums, trumpets and horns blared forth at once, and their combined sound grew immensely.
Tata shvetair hayair yukte mahatisyandane sthitau madhavah pandavaschaiva divyau shankhau pradadhmatuh.
And then, from amidst the Pandava army, seated in a glorious chariot drawn by white horses, Lord Madhava and Arjuna blew their divine conch shells in response.
Panchajanyam hrishikeshu devadattam dhananjayah paundram dadhmau mahashankham bhima karma vrukodarah.
Lord Hrishikesha or Krishna blew his conch shell called the Panchajanyam, and Arjuna blew his devadattam. The mighty and valorous Bhima blew his huge conch called paundram.
Ananta vijayam raja Kunti putro yudhishthirah nakulah sah devascha sughoshamani pushpakau.
Sanjaya says to Dhritarashtra, O king, upon hearing these conch shells, King Yudhishthira blew the Ananta Vijayam, while Nakula and Sahadeva blew Sughosha and Manipushpaka respectively.
Kashyascha parameshvasah shikhandi cha maharathah dhrishtadyumno viratascha satyakischa parajitah drupado draupadeyascha sarvashah prithivipate saubhadrascha mahabahuh shankhan dadhmuh pruthak pruthak.
The excellent archer and king of Kashi, the great warrior Shikhandi, Drishtadyumna, Virata and the invincible Satyaki, Drupada, the five sons of Draupadi and the mighty armed Abhimanyu, son of Subhadra, all blew their respective conch shells.
Saghoshodharta rashtranam hridayani vyadarayat nabhascha prithivim chaiva tumulo vyanunadayan.
The terrific sound thundered across the sky and earth and shattered the hearts of your sons, O Dhritarashtra.
Atha vyavasthitan drishtva dhartarashtran kapidhvajah pravritte shastra sampate dhanurudyamya pandavah.
At that time, the son of Pandu, with the symbol of Hanuman on his chariot, Arjuna, looked at your sons and took up his bow.
Hrishikesham tadavakyam idamaha mahipate.
O king, he then spoke these following words to Lord Krishna.
Arjuna uvacha sena yorubhayor madhye ratham sthapayamechyuta yavadetan nirikshaham yodhukaman avasthitan kairmaya saha yodhavyam asmin ranasamudyame.
O Achyuta, please take my chariot to the middle of both armies so that I may look at the warriors who are eager for battle. I wish to look at those people with whom I must fight in this great war.
Yotsyamanana vekshehaṁ ya etetra samāgatāha dhārtarāṣṭrasya durbuddher yuddhe priyachikīrṣavaha.
I desire to see those who have come here to fight on the side of the evil-minded son of Dhritarashtra, wishing to please him.
Sanjaya uvacha eva mukto hrishikesho gudakeshena bharata sena yorubhayor madhye sthapayitva rathottamam.
Sanjaya spoke these following words to Dhritarashtra. Having thus been addressed by Arjuna, Lord Krishna then drew the magnificent chariot between the two armies.
Bhishma Drona Pramukhatah Sarvesham cha Mahikshitam Uvacha Partha Pashyaitan Samavetan Kuruniti.
In the presence of Bhishma, Dronacharya and all the other kings, Shri Krishna said, O Partha, behold these Kurus gathered here.
Tatra pashyat sthitan parthah pitrunatha pitamahan acharyan matulan bhratrun putran pautran sakhins tatha shvashuran suhrudans chaiva senayorubhayorapi.
There, Arjuna could see stationed in both armies his fathers, grandfathers, teachers, maternal uncles, brothers, cousins, sons, grandnephews, fathers-in-law, and friends.
Tansamikshya sakaunteyaha sarvan bandhu navasthitan kripaya paraya vishto vishidannidam abravit.
Seeing all his relatives present there, Arjuna, the son of Kunti, was overwhelmed with compassion and with deep sorrow spoke the following words.
Arjuna uvacha drishtve mam svajanam krishna yuyutsum samupasthitam sidanti mama gatrani mukham cha parishushyati vepathuscha sharire me roma harshascha jayate gandivam sramsate hastat tvakchaiva paridahyate nacha shaknum yavasthatum bhramati vachami manah nimittani cha pashyami viparitani keshava nacha shreyo nu pashyami hatva svajana mahave.
O Krishna, seeing my own men who have assembled here for battle, my limbs are giving way and my mouth is drying up. My whole body shudders. My hair is standing on end. My bow, the Gandiva, is slipping from my hand and my skin is burning all over. My head is spinning in confusion. I am unable to hold myself steady any longer. O Krishna, I only see omens of misfortune. I do not see how any good can come from killing my own people in this battlefield.
Nakankshe vijayam Krishna na cha rajyam sukhani cha kim no rajye na govinda kim bhogair jivite nava yesham arthe kankshitam no rajyam bhoga sukhani cha ta ime vasthita yuddhe pranas tyaktva dhanani cha.
He then says, O Krishna, I do not see the victory, kingdom or the pleasures that come after it. Of what use is a kingdom, pleasures or even life itself, when the very people for whom we covet them are standing before us for war, setting aside their lives and their riches.
Acharya pitara putra tathaiva cha pitamahah matula shvashura pautra shyala sambandhinas tatha.
Teachers, fathers, sons, grandfathers, maternal uncles, grandsons, fathers-in-law, grandnephews, brothers-in-law, and other relatives are present here.
Etan nahantum ichhami ghnatopi madhusudana अपि त्रैलोक्य राज्यस्य हेतो किं नु महि कृते।
ओ मधुसूदन, आई डू नॉट हैव द स्लाइटेस्ट विश ऑफ किलिंग देम, इवन इफ दे अटैक मी, इवन इफ आई गेट द डोमिनियन ओवर थ्री वर्ल्ड्स, डेफिनेटली नॉट फॉर अ पीस ऑफ लैंड।
निहत्य धार्तराष्ट्रान्नः का प्रीति स्याद् जनार्दन, पापमेवाश्रयेदस्मान् हत्वैतानाततायिनः।
ओ कृष्ण, वॉट प्लेजर विल आई डिराइव फ्रॉम किलिंग द सन्स ऑफ धृतराष्ट्र, इवन इफ दे इंस्टिगेटेड द वॉर, सिन विल सर्टनली फॉल अपॉन अस इफ वी स्ले देम।
तस्मान्नार्हा वयं हन्तुं धार्तराष्ट्रान् स्वबान्धवान्, स्वजनं हि कथं हत्वा सुखिनः स्याम माधव।
हेन्स वी आर नॉट वेल ऑफ टू किल आवर ओन कजन्स, द सन्स ऑफ धृतराष्ट्र एंड फ्रेंड्स। ओ माधव, हाउ कैन वी होप टू बी हैप्पी बाय किलिंग आवर ओन पीपल।
यद्यप्येते न पश्यन्ति लोभोपहत चेतसः, कुलक्षय कृतं दोषं मित्रद्रोहे च पातकम्।
ओ जनार्दन, इवन इफ दीज कौरवास आर ब्लाइंडेड बाय देयर ग्रीड, ए मिस्टेक दैट इज डन टुवर्ड्स हार्मिंग द फैमिली इज वर्स देन हार्मिंग फ्रेंडशिप्स।
कथं न ज्ञेयमस्माभिः पापादस्मान् निवर्तितुं, कुलक्षय कृतं दोषं प्रपश्यद्भिर्जनार्दन। कुलक्षये प्रणश्यन्ति कुलधर्माः सनातनाः, धर्मे नष्टे कुलं कृत्स्नम् अधर्मोऽभिभवत्युत।
When a house and its members are destroyed, its traditions and laws are lost. Once the laws are completely gone, anarchy prevails.
अधर्माभिभवात् कृष्ण प्रदुष्यन्ति कुलस्त्रियः, स्त्रीषु दुष्टासु वार्ष्णेय जायते वर्णसंकरः।
Once unlawful activities are on the rise, women are no longer safe. With that corruption, O descendant of Rishni, the Varnashrama Dharma gets spoilt.
Sankaro narakayaiva kulagnanam kulasya cha patanti pitaro hyesham luptapindodaka kriyaha.
Once the Varnashrama Dharma is lost, life becomes hell for both the perpetrators and the victims. Deprived of the ritualistic offerings, even the ancestors of such corrupt families fall.
Doshairetaih kulagnanam varnasankarakarakaih utsadyante jati dharmah kuladharmascha shashvatah.
Due to these kinds of mistakes which hurt one's own family and leads to the destruction of the Varnashrama Dharma, the eternal social and the family laws are ruined.
Utsanna kuladharmanam manushyanam janardana narake niyatam vaso bhavatityanushushruma.
O Janardana, I have heard that those who destroy family traditions dwell in hell for an indefinite period of time.
Aho bata mahat papam kartum yavasita vayam yadrajya sukha lobhena hantum svajana mudyatah.
Alas, how strange it is that we have set our minds on performing such a great sin. Driven by the desire for kingly pleasures, we are intent on killing our own people.
Yadi mama pratikaram ashastram shastrapanayah dhartarashtrarane hanyuhu tanme kshematram bhavet.
I think that it is better for me to lay down my arms and let the sons of Dhritarashtra kill me in this war.
Sanjaya uvacha eva muktva arjuna sankhe rathopastha upavishat visrujya sasharam chapam shoka samvignamanasah.
Sanjaya said, and speaking thus, Arjuna was overwhelmed with grief. He abandoned his bow and arrows and fell into the chariot.
Om Tat Sat Iti Shrimad Bhagavad Gita Su उपनिषत्सु ब्रह्मविद्यायां योगशास्त्रे श्रीकृष्णार्जुनसंवादे अर्जुनविषादयोगो नाम प्रथमोऽध्यायः.
And thus ends the first chapter by the name of Arjuna Vishada Yoga. This is taken from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, a conversation between Lord Krishna and Arjuna on the science of yoga, which is the knowledge of the ultimate reality called as Brahma Vidya.
Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha.